Brian, the Revolutionary Students Union scheduled the room, but I know that it was Brian and the Salt Lake Dream Team that did all the real work, so let's get another round of applause for them. I'm so glad to see such courageous people as the walkers who are walking the American dream so that we actually have equality. But there's an issue that I am not so happy to talk about, and that is Carlos Mumpitz. Some of you may recognize the name from the movie Walkout. Carlos Mumpitz is a Chicano civil rights leader, anti-war, immigration, labor leader all over Los Angeles. He was one of the organizers for the 2006 mega marches. He was one of the original founders of the Brown Berets. He fought to get women's and Chicano and ethnic studies on campus throughout the whole UC campuses. And he's being targeted by harassment by the FBI, and they're basically trying to frame him. You can find out more on stopfbi.net, but his trial is next Tuesday. And so we're asking everyone to call in to the district attorney to demand that the charges be dropped. So these are fightbacks. They cover this sort of case. They should be sitting in a chair just back there. We normally ask for 50 cents. Take one if it's free. If you were gonna give money, please donate to the wonderful cause of the Campaign for the American Dream. But please, please, please find out about Carlos Mumpitz. He needs your solidarity. This is not just an attack on an anti-war leader or a union leader. This is an attack on those people who have citizenship, who are willing to fight for immigrant rights, and it's something that affects all of us. So thank you so much, and thank you for your time, Brian.
Thank you, Greg. At this moment, can I ask the presidency of the Hispanic Latino Club to come up here? And can we get two representatives of Campaign for American Dream to come up here, please? This is beautiful Nora. She is former. Yeah, let's bring the current president up here as well, please. Give her a round of applause. And I will turn the time over to you.
I would just like to welcome the catwalkers here in Salt Lake Community College. I'm so privileged to have them here today, and it's been a great opportunity for me. And we also have. Alright, we also have a few funds that we had a dance for them during the semester, and we would like to give that to them today. We have a little check that we would like to give them as she was going to get it. So yeah, we had this dance. We received the video a few days after. It was amazing. You guys should have seen the video. But yes, we would like to present this check. Yes, $500 to the okay. Yeah, if we could get most of the SLCC members to come up, I know.
Yes, please come up. Let me move this. Yeah. Can you get a good picture? Thank you, HLC, for putting on such a great event. Please give another round of applause, HLC. But the walkers of the Campaign for American Dream, and I will turn the microphone over to them now. So, thank you. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. We just want to thank you on behalf of Campaign for American Dream for coming and supporting us, especially for this awesome check. We always wanted to see a big check like that. Thank you. We are Campaign for American Dream. We started on March 10th. And we are walking nearly 3,000 miles to reach Washington, D.C. on November 2nd. So far, we've walked about 700 miles, and we still have a couple more to go. Our reason for walking, you know, is unity, equality, and diversity, and basically just connecting the dots as we walk through every single state, so that on November 2nd, you guys can join us. Hopefully, you know, we have a busload from every single state, and on November 2nd, we can show up, you know, at the White House or march down towards the White House and say, you know, we're here, we exist, we're not criminals, and, you know, this is the face of undocumented youth.
So we're a little exhausted. We walked here. Well, I walked half of the way. We kind of split up. Yeah.
I walked the first half, but Meadow here, she walked the whole way.
And she had no sleep. She actually didn't sleep or Jonathan. They were up all night. We were working on stuff that was going to happen today. So another round of applause for both of them for... You know, so once again, thanks to everyone for being here. We know that, you know, it's late and people are taking time off their schedule to show up and see what we're about and why we're walking 3,000 miles. So once again, thanks everyone for showing up. And so, yeah, just a little bit about why we decided to start walking and the importance of, you know, fighting for a cause and knowing that the Dream Act is something that will help all of us here. We know that, you know, in the past, the Dream Act has almost made it by 5 votes, and we understand that that's not the solution to, or just the solution that we want. We know that we want to legalize our parents. We know that we don't want to throw our parents under the bus. We know that as undocumented youth, we were brought here so that we can have a better life, because that's what our parents wanted for us. And I think that we're here to show those people, and not only undocumented, but people who are documented, to let them know that people like us want to have an education and that we are fighting for that, to have a higher education and go to join the military. I believe that we all have the right to choose what we want, and, you know, as we know, a lot of undocumented youth have really stepped up and stood at the forefront of this movement. You know, for many years, politicians, organizations, and people would tell us to not share our stories because we were going to get deported, because, you know, sharing our stories was the risk that we were taking. And so as undocumented youth, we have taken that risk and we have said, you know what, we're ready to speak for ourselves. We're ready to put a face to the struggle and show people what we're about. We're not criminals, we're not illegals. And, you know, just for the people that don't understand why we're doing this, and also letting them know that we all have different stories, that we all come from different parts of the country. We actually didn't meet till a week before the walk began. We have been on calls and added each other on Facebook, and, you know, just when we met, we were just like, man, we're ready to do this walk. We can't believe that we're walking. You know, every day we wake up in a different location, in a different place, in a different environment, snow, desert, just everything that you can imagine, running for mud. So we've had very, very cool experiences walking, but we've also met a lot of amazing people throughout the way that have helped us on our journey. Without the community, we wouldn't be able to do this. And so, who knows what the Dream Act is here? Mostly everyone. So I think I'm going to pass it down to Remy so she can talk a little bit about the Dream Act and what it means.
So the Dream Act stands for Development, Release, and Education for Alien Minors, DREAM. And what it would do, the Dream Act would, it's a piece of legislation that was introduced 11 years ago now, back in 2001. And, you know, what it would do is it would help the undocumented immigrants who were brought into this country at a young age. There's an age limit to it, 15 years or younger. That's in the 2010 version. And, you know, they would have to have grown up in the U.S., you know, there'd be a certain time that they would have lived here, go through a U.S. high school, graduate a U.S. high school, or get a GED, and to have entered into a higher education institution, two-year, four-year, or serve in the military, and have good moral character. So, the DREAM Act, you know, would help, there's about 2.1 million, an estimate of 2.1 million students, undocumented immigrants, who would be eligible for the DREAM Act. So that's a little bit about the DREAM Act, and yeah. So I'll just start. So we'll start by sharing our stories, because, you know, we share our stories, that's what we're here to do, because, you know,